Right, let's try this again. This is a stone, this is another stone. You put them together, and what do you have?
A couple of stones!
Right, but how much is that? One stone plus another stone.
Some stones!
Okay, alright. You have one stone, and then you have another stone, and you have this unit right here. And then you add another stone to this. What happens? What do you have in here?
Two stones!
Yes!
And another stone! No!
The first thing you said. Now, you have one stone and another stone. What do you have in here?
A couple of stones!
No! The other thing you said.
Some stones!
You have this stone, and then you have this stone. Together, they form a number. One stone and another stone. How many stones are in here, in this group?
Oh! I get it! A few stones! Not enough to build anything, if you ask me!
This is a feast. This is another feast.
Yes!
Hello my good friends, how are you? My name is Ari Therger and today I'm going to talk about the Vikings numerical system, if there was any. How exactly did the Vikings wrote numbers? This was a question posed by one of my patrons, the very person who gave me this jersey. You guys like it? Nordic stuff, awesome. Thank you very much, my dear friend Paul Dobson, for this wonderful gift. All right, everyone is always concerned with the Nordic runic alphabet, but we often forget about the numbers. Quite obviously, the Nordic peoples knew about numbers. But concerning runes, they have been first used to express ideas, emotions, to express understandings of the physical and metaphysical. And only later on, during the Viking period, the runes started to be used as a form of writing. So, understandably, a lot of runes were lost along the way when you pass from a complex variety of symbols to express infinite concepts and notions to a limited set of letters to compose words that came to replace symbols. When it comes to numbers, virtually every culture around the world knows the difference between one rock and two rocks, subtract and add units. In the Viking Age, most Scandinavians depended on trading, so the simple basic notions of mathematics were needed. And we see in Norse mythology, for instance, the importance of certain numbers, certain quantities of something, not to mention calendars, counting the days, months, and the seasons. But because Scandinavians of the Viking period came from a long history of a couple of thousands of years using runic symbols to express ideas, there wasn't really a specific symbol to express a specific number and its value. So when the runes started to be used as an alphabet, the rare occasions a number was expressed in a written form was by the use of the runes. We can see this in Viking Age rune inscriptions, but it's very rare. To express a number, the entire word of a number was written in runes, or even rarer, the rune, which was the alphabetical equivalent of the first letter of the number, was introduced in a runic inscription to express the number. I said this in the most confusing way possible, I think. Even I have to pause for a second to think about what I have said. Let me give you an example. The Old Norse words for the numbers 1, 2, and 3 are hein, þeir, and hrir. So to express these numbers in written form using the runes, the Vikings either wrote the entire word of each number with the Viking Age set of runes, the younger Futhark, a row of 16 runes, or they expressed the number by using the first letter of the number. In the case of Hein, Tver, and Trir, it would be He, Ti, and Torn. Of course, this isn't as simple as it as this because we have to take in mind that Old Norse was put aside rapidly, and during the Viking Age, when the runes started to be used as an alphabet, we have at least three countries with distinct languages, and those same languages in a span of 500 years also had great changes: Norwegian, Swedish, and Danish. So because the languages separate themselves from Old Norse and have their own distinct evolution through time, the runes also changed. So writing numbers with runes wasn't only in Old Norse, but also in medieval Norwegian, Swedish, and Danish, depending on the period and the location of the rune inscriptions. The runes used were from the younger Futhark, but there were several versions of the younger Futhark. Another thing to take in mind is that, of course, some numbers start with the exact same letter, so it gets confusing. In that aspect, two runes were used to represent the number. For instance, 6 and 7, 6 and Sjall, both start with an S, so 7 would be represented with an S and the letter that comes next to it. But take notice, this is very rare indeed. Most common is to find the entire word of the number written in runes, and even that is also quite rare. Thank you so much, my good friends. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoy my new jersey. Thank you so much for watching. See you on the next video, and as always, Pokrilo.